Good afternoon. I've never made a video like this before, but I wanted to put forward a short response to Hank's nuanced video on natural gas, which I'm linking below. In combination with my ongoing PhD research on climate change activism, which I will also link, it made me think about political polarization and the seeming willingness of the politically frustrated to reject expert knowledge in areas as diverse as reproductive and sexual health and climate change. Another factor is that in order to be meaningful, policies to control climate change need to be kept in place for the indefinite future. It's not much use to not exploit a coal or a gas field today if we do so in 10 years' time. All this suggested to me the idea of a pragmatist political movement working within existing political structures to implement the agenda that knowledge and evidence support. That's in contrast to a new political party, which would need policies of all kinds, as well as in contrast with efforts to replace the whole system, like by overthrowing capitalism, which sounds hard, may take a long time, and wouldn't necessarily solve climate change. This pragmatist movement could encourage good candidates, call out bad ones, call for action from governments, improve systems of governance, like by addressing gerrymandering and the first-past-the-post electoral system, encourage productive multilateral diplomacy, and international cooperation. One defining feature would be willingness to at least contemplate and discuss anything that might help, even technologies like geoengineering. Importantly, the movement would be meant to be accessible to anyone, regardless of their political preconceptions. That means not assuming our pet political projects, whether those are universal basic income and the nationalization of the fossil fuel industry, or flat taxes, or rewilding, or rebuilding local economies, are necessary for solving climate change. There are three reasons for this. The first is all along itis, people saying that whatever actions they have been recommending for decades already are now all the more necessary because of climate change. This is grabbing on climate as justification, more than focusing on which solutions are really best for its protection. The second is to try to overcome distrust and reduce polarization, making it harder for opponents to assume or claim that the whole movement is an ideological enterprise with preset goals. Beyond planetary survival and human welfare into the future, other goals can be taken as not necessarily agreed. Finally, unless we do avoid catastrophic climate change, none of our other projects will be meaningful in the long term. It would be an achievement to fix a national pension system so that it will stay solvent and functional to 2100, but meaningless if the planet warms by 4 or 5 degrees Celsius and totally undermines the basis of that society. Maintaining a habitable and welcoming world is necessary for all worthwhile human undertakings. The idea would be to stay grounded in a ruthless adherence to fact over ideology. We do need values and emotions to decide how we ought to behave, but our choices should always be of an experts agree that this will probably help achieve your goal variety. Another important activity could be building communities and resilience. We will all need aid in all manner of unexpected and unprecedented circumstances going forward, whether it's because our agricultural land has lost productivity, river flow is threatened or failing, or extreme weather is forcing us to change or replace systems that have been in place for a long time. Anyway, I thought nerdfighters might be able to bring their own knowledge and intelligence to considering what a movement capable of driving effective and durable climate change mitigation policies might look like. I look forward to hearing all of your responses. Thank you.